I'm going to music special, and can't you tell that I feel swell? I'm gonna clap along and sing my favorite song in order to listen to music special. Welcome to lesson number 28. I'm glad you're here. Let's talk about the bassoon to begin.
What instrument is that? What instrument is that? How does it sound? Where is it found? But first of all, you must tell me now. What instrument is that?
The modern bassoon dates from the 17th century and is considered to be the base of the oboe family. Made of wood, the instrument consists of five sections that are folded together with the bell facing up. The bassoon has a bocal that holds its double reed and a tone often described as dark, reedy, and chuckling. The bassoon's key is C, and its music is typically written in the bass and tenor clefs. Bassoons are played in orchestras, concert bands, and chamber music. So the bassoon comes from the 1600s. It's considered the base of the oboe family because it's got the lowest sound of all the oboes. We learn that it's made of wood. Remember, the bell of an instrument is the big part that the sound comes out of. We learned that its tone is dark, reedy, and chuckling. It's a very interesting sounding instrument. Let's listen to a wonderful performance on the bassoon. Time to play Guess What Instrument.
Guess what? Guess what? Guess what instrument? Guess what? Guess what? Guess what instrument is making that sound?
On your screen is a guitar, a trombone, and an alp horn. Listen. That was a guitar. On your screen is a serpent, a snare drum, and a viola. Listen. That was a viola. On your screen is a xylophone, a sitar, and a euphonium. Listen. That was a xylophone. Now let's discuss articulation.
Thank you.
articulation. In the last 2 weeks, we learned about the words and signs that indicate what speed, slow or fast, and volume, soft to loud, a musical selection is to be played. In addition to those, notes may be performed in different ways. The manner in which a note is performed is called articulation. Legato is one form of articulation. That was when we blurred the notes together, we slurred them. So in this box below, we have a list of some articulation symbols, their Italian meanings, and their English counterparts. Staccato, when there's a little dot above or below a note, means that you play the note very quickly. Play the note short and detached. The Italian word means detached. Below the staccatos, we have accents. For those, we play the note louder and with a special emphasis. Sforzando means a sudden, strong accent. The Italian word means forcing. Sforzando. Tenuto. Those little lines above and below the note means that you hold the note for its full value. The Italian word means held. And a fermata. My piano teacher used to call those a bird's eye because they look like little bird's eyes. They mean that we hold the note longer than its normal value, approximately twice the normal duration. Let's talk about another famous composer. Johannes Brahms brought a grand richness to music at the end of the Romantic period. Born into a very poor family, he lived in a tenement and learned to play the piano to support his family. A friend helped him find musical connections to fellow composer and lifelong friend Robert Schumann, who proclaimed him a musical genius. Leading a frugal life, Brahms was a contradictory person, often appearing untidy and rude. As a composer, Brahms's music was recognized and rewarded during his lifetime. Brahms looked back to the music of the past instead of the sound of the future. His songs, called Lieder, reflect classical era balance combined with romantic style emotions. He used his own German language instead of Latin in the choral masterpiece, German Requiem. This shocked his audiences, yet made Brahms very famous and popular. Obsessed with perfection and detail, Brahms took approximately 5 years to write the Symphony No. 1 in C minor. That's what we're listening to right now. He destroyed any compositions that did not live up to his high standards, so the music we have left from him is only his best work. Now let's talk about the musical genre called Motown. Motown started up in Detroit in the 1950s. Detroit is called the Motor City, and Motown is a sort of nickname for Motortown. Motown is a special kind of music. It's a little bit soul music, a little bit blues, a little bit popular music. The melodies are rich and beautiful. The producers of Motown music used strings and horns in their songs too. Some of my favorite Motown artists are The Temptations, Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, the Supremes, and the Detroit Spinners. Thank you for coming again. As always, thank you for your attention and for participating. I will see you next week. Bye.
Well, I'm going to music special, and can't you tell that I feel swell? I'm gonna clap along and sing my favorite song, and all to listen music special.